Welcome to Nalla Narasimha Reddy Education Society Group of Institutions. Integrated Campus accredited by NAC and MBA. This is Kameshwari, Department of Civil Engineering. My subject, Watershed Management. In that, the unit is Principles of Soil Erosion and its Controls Methods. How? Soil are eroded and its what are the different techniques for used to control soil erosion. The different techniques already we are discussed in previous class. What are the different types of soil erosion techniques, prevent soil erosion techniques, and how soils are eroded? The soil are eroded during heavy rainfall over a period of time, 24 hours. Some water will be infiltrate and remaining water will be stagnate on a ground surface, and that water will be flooded over the ground surface. Due to that flooding process, soil are also follow up and false soils are also eroded in plain area. But we in that plain area, that overall area covered by using vegetation or any crop. So the main advantage to cover the crop or vegetation on a poor land, so it increases the infiltration and reduces the soil erosion, and runoff losses also we can reduce. In that prevention of soil erosion, we can go for different techniques that are vegetation, burning, retaining wall, construction of retaining wall, and mulching and furrows. Different types already we can discuss in a previous class. Now the today's topic is soil moisture conservation techniques. The soil moisture conservation techniques are how soils moisture conservation techniques. These are also related to in previous class. How soils are conserved by covering overall land with vegetation. That root zone holds the soil and water, so soil moisture content will be increased. So now the introduction is to increase the moisture availability to the agricultural crops. It is necessary to drop in situ moisture conservation techniques in addition to the large scale soil and moisture conservation and water harvesting structure in the watershed, in the watershed areas. And the principle behind the recommendation of different practices is to increase the infiltration by reducing the rate of runoff temporarily, and also water on the surface of the soil to increase the opportunity time for infiltration, and modifying the land configuration for inlet plot water harvesting. So behind the recommendation of different practices means increase the infiltration by reducing the rate of runoff, by reducing the rate of runoff. And earlier stages efforts for moisture conservation were concentrated upon construction of various types of berms across the land slope to control the soil erosion and to conserve the soil and increase the moisture. In on the erosion control measures, however, accommodation of water against the structures rather than its proper and uniform deformation distribution in the interterraced areas and at times lead to reduces in crop yield. All the erosion controls measures, like, however, water against the structures rather than its proper and uniform distribution in the interterraced areas, and at the end at times lead to reduces in crop yield. And also to overcome these problems, in-situ conservation techniques are recommended. Generally, deep digging and subsoiling decreases the soil penetration resistance and also increase the profile water, increases the profile water use when compared with the conventional tillages. Due to general techniques, subsoiling and deep decreases the soil penetration resistance and also increase the profile water use. And when compared with conventional tillages, and easy to measure conservation methods are increase the moisture availability to the agricultural crops in the individual farmer fields, and also increase infiltration and percolation of rainwater into the root profile. The in situ measure conservation techniques are recommended the following. So by in situ measurements means increases the infiltration and also percolation of rainwater into the root profile. The following are the in situ measures. In that, the first one is deep tillage. Deep tillage. This is the one of the method for soil conservation technique. That are deep tillage means normal tillage depth to modify the physical or chemical properties of soil, and also includes tillage operation commonly referred to as deep plunging. The figure shows the plunging, deep plunging, subsoiling, ripping, or row till, which are carried out on an need basis. In deep tillage, they are following deep ripping, planking, plugging, and subsoil methods. Keeps helps to soil moisture in the soil by enhancing the water infiltration and reducing the soil erosion. And next one is mulching. This one is already discussed in previous. These are different types. In this method, one of the simplest method conserve the soil moisture. That is different ways. The different methods of plantings or crop production or gardening mulching. These are divided into two types: organic mulches and inorganic mulches. Now the organic such as straw include wood chips, shavings, Coca-Cola beans, and crushed corn cobs and grass chipping, etc. And inorganic are stone bricks and ties, gravels, pebbles, and weed barriers, recycled rubber tires. These are the inorganic mulches. So the process is used both commercial crop production and in gardening, and when applied correctly can dramatically improve soil productivity. So we can go for organic and inorganic. And advantages of organic this mulching is enhancement of soil with nutrients essential for growing plants, protect from soil erosion. The figure shows the mulching, one of the technique protect from soil erosion and also reduce compaction from the impact of heavy rains, and also maintain more even soil temperature. You can maintain more even soil temperatures. And basin listing. This is another method for soil conservation. The basin provides maximum time to rain water for infiltration to soil. This method is provides maximum time to rain water for infiltration into soil. Here for row by rows, here runoff losses will be reduced. So conserve the water and infiltration into the soil. So soil moisture capability will be increased. In this method of soil and water conservation basins are constructed using special implement.